There are two statues of Mickey Mantle in the state of Oklahoma. One is installed outside Oklahoma City's Chickasaw Bricktown Ballpark and shows the switch-hitting legend batting left. This 7-foot, 6-inch bronze statue stands on a 3-foot granite base at the ballpark's third base pavilion and was dedicated on the ballpark's opening day on April 16, 1998. But our feature today focuses on a nearly identical Mickey Mantle statue that stands further north, nearly 200 miles, in his hometown of Commerce, Oklahoma. This statue depicts Mantle batting right. Frozen in time as if he just slugged one of his mammoth home runs, the 9-foot-tall bronze statue stands just beyond the center field fence of the Commerce High School baseball field. Perched atop a granite base inside a miniature baseball diamond, this Mantle statue weighs over a ton and is named after one of Mickey's nicknames, the Commerce Comet. And today, we'll share with you stories and information about how all this came about, as well as show you one of the miniature bronze replicas produced as part of a fundraising campaign for the larger-than-life-size version. So keep it right here on this episode of History and Relics. Mickey Charles Mantle was born to Elvin, also known as Mutt, and Lavelle Mantle on October 20, 1931 in Spavinaw, Oklahoma. When he was 4 years old, his family moved to Commerce, about 5 miles north of Miami, where his father worked in lead and zinc mines. Mutt named his son in honor of Mickey Cochran, a Hall of Fame catcher who played for the Athletics and Tigers. Later in life, Mickey expressed relief that his father had not known Cochran's true first name, as he would have hated to be named Gordon. Mutt was an avid baseball fan and instilled the love of the game in his son. They would spend hours practicing in front of their old tin barn. Mantle batted left-handed against his father whenever they practiced together. However, the baseball legend would bat right-handed when practicing with his grandfather, Charles Mantle, and would later be considered by many to be the greatest switch hitter of all time. Baseball was his first love, but he was an all-around athlete at Commerce High School, playing basketball as well as football, to which he was offered a football scholarship by the University of Oklahoma. His football career nearly ended his athletic ambitions and almost his life. Kicked in the left shin during a practice game during his sophomore year, his ankle soon became infected with osteomyelitis, a crippling disease that was incurable just a few years earlier. A midnight drive to Tulsa, Oklahoma, enabled him to be treated with newly available penicillin, saving his swollen leg from amputation. Mickey was discovered by Yankee scout Tom Greenwade in 1948 while playing for the local Baxter Springs Whiz Kids. On graduation day, Greenwade signed Mickey to a professional contract at $140 a month, plus an $1,150 signing bonus. By 1951, he was playing with the New York Yankees, after a brief stint in the minor leagues. Sometime in 1988 or 1989, Commerce, Oklahoma civic leaders proposed a monument, park, and museum that would honor the New York Yankee slugger and attract tourists to northeastern Oklahoma. The Sooner Pride Committee, a local nonprofit group of about 30 civic boosters, including chairman Carl Daugherty, had raised $25,000 towards its $125,000 first phase goal to build a monument and park. Future phase two plans were to raise some $500,000 to build a museum to house memorabilia for Mantle's 18-year major league career that ended with his retirement in 1969. Other programs and community involvement also assisted in the efforts. Soon, some 17 and a half acres of land was purchased on the other side of State Highway 69, or Mickey Mantle Boulevard, and adjacent to the Commerce High School athletic field. An architect was hired to come up with a design. The result? Detailed plans for a museum complex featuring four baseball diamonds and a building with interactive exhibits, at a total cost that approached $10 million. People involved in the museum project give differing accounts of why it later fell through. Some say there just wasn't enough money raised to start the museum, and others question whether there would have been enough visitors to sustain it. The initial plan for a statue included it being a 16-foot monument with a 9-foot bronze of Mantle sitting on a 7-foot Oklahoma-shaped granite base. However, these plans were later revised. Nick Calcagno was commissioned to do the bronze of Mickey Mantle. Calcagno, a well-renowned artist and sculptor, was the chairman of the art department at Northeast Oklahoma A&M in Miami. His wife, Carol, was a member of the board of directors for the Northeast Oklahoma Foundation. Calcagno initially designed the bronze statue in the 1970s, and although plans eventually fell through for the museum, Calcagno had smaller versions of the statue casted in the late 1980s. That casting would eventually serve as a way for the Sooner Pride Committee to raise needed funds, as well as it being the template for the 9-foot-tall bronze statue that welcomes visitors to Mickey Mantle Field in Commerce to this day. These fundraising efforts in the late 1980s included the selling of limited edition prints of Mickey Mantle done by sports illustrator Ted Watts of Oswego, Kansas, as well as 9 and 20-inch bronze replicas of the proposed statue. The 16 by 20-inch art prints were priced at $298 for premium numbers. That's the equivalent of about $675 today, and $150 each for prints numbered greater than 100. They also sold blue and white Mickey Mantle Boulevard street signs at $38 each, and packages of 7 metal Mickey Mantle buttons or cloth patches for $15. The 20-inch statues were initially priced at $5,000 each. That's over $11,000 today, and they were limited to just 31 pieces, 31 representing the year Mantle was born, 1931. The 9-inch bronze statues were of an edition size of 298, which represented Mickey's lifetime batting average. The smaller scale bronze statues were priced at $536. That's $1,200 today. 536 representing the number of home runs Mantle hit during his 18-year career. The Sooners and other fundraising initiatives for the statue did take a while, but in the end, were successful. The statue was finally dedicated in October 2010. However, neither Mickey Mantle nor Nick Calcagno survived to see its dedication. Mickey died on August 13, 1995, and Nick passed on August 19, 2003. The 20-inch bronze statue of Mickey Mantle would later find its way to the Smithsonian in 2014 and was later gifted to the museum by Nick's wife Carol in 2015. For your viewing pleasure, we'd like to show you now our piece, the 9-inch bronze replica of the larger-than-life-size statue of Mickey Mantle in Commerce, Oklahoma. Our statue is number 27 of 298. The statue measures 10.5 inches high, 11 inches wide, and 4.5 inches deep, including the black marble base, and weighs approximately 8 pounds. It comes with all the original paperwork from the Sooners fundraising campaign. Let us now show you around the statue and do a comparison of its larger counterpart. Mickey Mantle is still regarded today as one of the greatest baseball players of all time. Just take a look at some of these stats. He was a 20-time All-Star. He played in 12 World Series and he won 7 championships. He was a 3-time American League MVP, and in 1956, he was the American League batting champion, RBI leader, and he won the Triple Crown. Mickey was also a 4-time American League home run leader. And speaking of home runs, he hit 536 home runs in his 18-year career. In 1962, he won the Gold Glove Award, and he was inducted into the National Baseball Hall of Fame in 1974. And if you happen to have either his 1952 Topps or 1951 Bowman rookie cards in your collection, especially in a high grade, you may just have enough for retirement, as these two cards can set you back tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars today, if not more. In fact, Mickey Mantle collectibles, especially anything signed or used by Mantle, are amongst the most sought-after items in the sports memorabilia hobby today. This bronze piece is no exception to that, especially due to it being commissioned and casted during his living years. It's certainly a piece with a great amount of history tied to it. And unlike most statues, this one actually ties to a real, greater-than-life-size counterpart that you can visit today in Mickey Mantle's hometown of Commerce, Oklahoma. So be sure to check it out. Thank you for joining us today. We hope you've enjoyed our program. If you like our content, we ask that you like, share, and subscribe to our channel. It costs nothing but means a lot to us and keeps us growing. You may also leave us a tip if you choose. A link is provided here on your screen as well as in the description area below. And until next time, everyone, this one is history.